Well, y'all, I'm getting ready to start on my buckets and getting them ready for the collards. So I got to redo the soil, build it up a little bit, add some greens and potting mix. I've got my wheelbarrow over here. I've got garden soil from around on that pile, and I've got several shovelfuls of ash in that potting soil that's in that wheelbarrow that I'm going to add to my buckets, because I've already mixed it up some. I'll mix it up a little bit more before I add it to that. But I do have to get my cucumber vines out of there. So that's what I'm going to do right now. this out. My collars are not going to need it. Trying to level up these buckets because I noticed some of them were leaning sideways a little bit. if I want that one in the middle or not. Might get too crowded, but I'm not sure how big they'll get since I'm putting them in pots. So, and I've got all this broken down. I had been putting leaves in that blue bucket from my plants, you know, my collards and my squash and everything else. And they've been broken down a little bit. I'm going to mix them in the buckets. And that's going to be plant food. I think I'll need as much dirt as I thought, but it's all broken down. Breaks down so it's almost like sludge. Smells pretty bad too, but the plants love it. Going to add some of my topsoil that's piled around on the other side of the house with my ash from the fireplace. Thank you. take some potting mix. Put a handful in each one. I wish I hadn't got such a big bag. Can't pick this up that easily. I need another handful. And I'm just going to stir it around and try to mix it in with that garden soil and the ash. I didn't put paper in this because I don't think it's needed. Because I had already built these buckets last year. So I'm not using very much potting mix at all. A couple of handfuls in each one. Whew. And they'll be ready to plant. started to take this middle bucket out. I may wish I had, I don't know. I might leave the middle bucket in just in case. They get so big that they want to topple over. That'll help keep them upright. Get some more compost tea over here. Now, those are ready to plant, y'all. take you over here and see them. See, I built them up and I got them kind of full because the collards are going to be really big. And I want them to be able to come up out of the bucket before they start spreading out and getting really big. And I think that'll do it. And later on, when I plant something else in it, if I need to, I can take some of the dirt out, put it in another pot. But there's room for, what, 3, 7, 8, 9 good size collard plants to go right there. And I'm going to fix these other buckets that I'm going to put in the little raised bed. The same way, I gotta start from scratch with those because they were used for water buckets, so I'm gonna have to build the dirt all the way from the bottom. And with it being in a raised bed, I don't have to put rocks around it like that. That was my fire pit. So I can run the mower around it and mow. And with the buckets in there, I can change it up easy next year if I wanna move the raised bed, put it somewhere else, or leave it there. You know, I can always fill it full of dirt and stuff there next year in the spring, but I can let my collards grow there for now, and we'll see what happens. So that is my plan, y'all. And you know, I've still got plenty of dirt around there on that pile, and I've still got plenty of ash in the fire pit around there where I had the fire last night, to be able to mix in with my soil to build my buckets inside the raised bed there. So that's the plan. Oh, I almost forgot. Another thing that's very important. I mixed up some insecticide with hot pepper spray. And it's very important to spray your soil, your pots, before you plant in them. That kills any rodents, bugs, insects, worms, whatever, in your soil. So when you go to transplant your collard plants in there, they don't eat your plants up. So I've got that right here. You notice I don't care if I get it around the fire pit, in the fire pit, it don't matter. It'll just help keep the ants and stuff away from your plants when you put them out here. Now, that definitely should be ready to be planted right now. So I'll bring you back later when I get ready to plant them or transplant my collards. I don't think most of them are quite big enough, but I might. Let's run see if there are any of them that's big enough to transplant. Got to come out here and get some more okra. It's growed since I picked okra yesterday. Look at that. Look at that. They grow overnight, y'all. Yeah, I might have a few. See if I got 9 in here that's looks like might be big enough. I don't want to pull them up if they're too small. See, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I think. There's a couple that are just barely big enough. I think I got enough to transplant over there, and we'll see what happens with them. Let's go around there and see. They get as big as my rutabagas and stuff did. They'll be growing out of those buckets like crazy. Took my gloves off, but I don't guess that matters because got in a spider web. I don't want to get them too deep. There's one, and I don't have to water them now because I just got through watering them, so that's a good deal. Get my foot out of there. The roots will go right down to where you put that compost, you know, the broken down leaves. That's where, because the roots are pretty long. So you plant them up to where the leaves start. And that puts the root, the end of the root, right down into where the... broken down leaves were. So that's going to help feed that root. I think I pulled up too many. Now And there's a fly that's dying. Put two of them in one of them, so if one dies, maybe the other one will live. I pulled up too many plants, but there, we've got 9 collard plants transplanted. I know my bucket's looking kind of nasty right now because I've got dirt all over them, but the next watering day, when I water with the garden hose, it'll wash it all off and it'll look better. But there's my collard, y'all. That's how you do it. You can build your soil and go ahead and transplant them right away. I have no makeup on this morning. I'm sweating already. But yeah, just like the hosta that we transplanted. As long as you don't put food items like bread, cake, sugary items, any kind of food items that come from the table that will attract ants, you don't want to do that. You want to put all that kind of stuff in your big compost pile. You don't want to put anything in a pot that you're getting ready to plant in that will attract ants. That's why I use, one reason I use the collard leaves, kale leaves, and stuff like that that's broken down. Or if they're not broken down already, hey, I'll just stuff the leaves down in there and they'll break down. But that's the way you do it, y'all. I got a collard for each pot. Just hope they survive. And you know, you saw I have plenty more out there in that tote to transplant. Some of them are not big enough quite yet. And I'm pushing it, you know, to transplant these. Yeah, I gotta go ahead and get those buckets fixed out there on the raised bed so I can get those ready to plant. I'll have, what, eight or 10 buckets in there by the time I'm through. So that'll be at least 10 more collard plants. So that's going to be plenty of collards, y'all. Plenty of collards, I think. I'll be giving collards away. Making tons of coleslaw and collard slaw. Cooking tons of collards. Well, I'm going to let y'all go. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to my videos. Y'all have a blessed day. See you on my next one. Love y'all. Bye now.